In my previous session, I introduced you to pin type insulators, suspension type insulators, and strain type. So we have two more types of commonly used insulators. Let's see what they are. So this is Dr. Uma Rao from RV College of Engineering, bringing you the lectures under the eSikshana program of VTU. So we have something called as post insulators. They are normally used as supports for bus bars in transformers, in substation yards, and also in switch gears to support the circuit breakers and for capacitor banks. So capacitor banks are normally connected for improvement of power factor and also as voltage profile builders. So they will improve the voltage profiles. So these post insulators, they are designed based on the IEC, ANSI and other standards, and they can be designed up to 1100 kV. It is composed of silicon rubber or one piece of porcelain. There is a single piece. And it's got a wide variety of applications because of its mechanical properties. See, your pin type insulator is clamped, it has a pin on the top by which it will be held at the crossbar of the pole. So the post type insulators are clamped. They are clamped to the line. So this is how, can you see this clamping, how they are clamped? So there's a groove on top and there will be a metallic clamp at both ends. And this is a porcelain post insulator. And these are all silicone post insulators. And this is how it will be mounted on the cross arms of the pole. So this is called as a cross arm. So this is how it will be mounted. And they can be used in areas. They have more number of petticoats than a pin type. So they're more robust to pollution. So you can use it where the atmosphere has large quantities of corrosive gases like sulfuric acid and nitrogenous compounds. And if you use it indoor, like say in an indoor switchyard, you can mount it both in the horizontal or the vertical. I have shown you the vertical position here. You can also mount it horizontally. And the ends are having clamps at both the ends. And you can use it for fixing bus bars to the post insulators. You can mount it on the supporting structure, the pole or the tower, at both horizontal position or in vertical position. The thing here is that it is made of a single piece of porcelain, and unlike a pin insulator which has a pin only at the top, this has a clamp arrangement both at the top and the bottom for fixing. The other type of insulator are stay insulators. These are normally used for lower voltage line, lower voltages, and they are rectangular in shape and used in distribution lines. So their size is small and they're used to provide insulation to stay wires. Stay wires are the wires which are connected to the poles to hold them firmly, to give them mechanical strength. Okay, so these stay insulators are designed to provide insulation in case the stay wire falls to the ground. These insulators ensure that they don't touch the ground. So the importance of this you can feel when the pole breaks. So we did see some videos where the wind, because of the wind, the pole just broke into two pieces. So in such cases, these stay insulators are very useful, and they are made typically from porcelain. So you see, this is how it is. And these are called as the stay wires. So you see, these stay wires hold, they provide support to the pole and connected to the, when we connect it to the ground. So the stay insulators are provided here so that in case it snaps, it provides insulation. I think you would have all seen such wires. These are called as stay wires. So these are the other two types type of insulators. Okay, so let's continue with the design in the next session.